हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग सर। अरुण सर, गुड मॉर्निंग, कैन यू हियर मी? गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग सर, गुड मॉर्निंग अरुण सर, कैन वी स्टार्ट द सेशन? गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल प्रेजेंट ओवर हियर। टुडेज मॉडरेटर प्रोफेसर मिस्टर पवन बाबू शर्मा इज नॉट अवेलेबल बिकॉज ड्यू टू द टेक्निकल एरर एंड बिहाफ ऑफ द पवन बाबू शर्मा, मिस्टर पवन बाबू शर्मा, आई एम हियर टू मॉडरेट दिस सेशन। टूडेज रिसोर्स पर्सन, एमिनेंट पर्सनैलिटी, डॉक्टर अरुण कुमार जिंदल, प्रिंसिपल महाराजा अग्रसेन कॉलेज ऑफ नर्सिंग, अग्रोहा, हरियाणा। एंड एज आई टोल्ड, टूडेज मॉडरेटर Professor Mr. Pavan Babu Sharma, HOD of Community Health Nursing, KS Nursing College, Gwalior. Due to technical error, is not able to connect this webinar. And today's resource person, Dr. Arun Kumar Jindal, Principal, Maharaja Agrasen College of Nursing, Agroha, Haryana. Sir is having thorough knowledge as well as skills in nursing and research. Good team coordinator with interpersonal skills as well as dedicated toward profession. If you will see the career development, he has completed the bachelor degree in 2002 from Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, Bangalore, master degree in 2007, Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, doctorate degree, Sri Venkateswar University, UP. And if you will see the work experience, he has worked in Nepal 2002 to 2004 as a junior lecturer in Ambala 2004 to 2005, as a lecturer in Dera Bassi, Punjab 2007 to 2008, as a lecturer in Panipat, Haryana 2008 to 2012, and now as a principal in Haryana state from 2012 to onwards. Now we will see the achievement. Lots of achievement are there, but we have due to the time we have not taken the all the achievements. The few achievements we have taken, he's running the YouTube channel, a very famous YouTube channel, Pulse Health and Educational Society. We also can subscribe and gain the lots of knowledge. He has published various articles in national as well as in international journals. He has organized various camps, national workshop, seminar, conference, and attend international conferences also. He has been appointed as an examiner in most universities of the India. He's also an author of various books and life member of the various nursing organization. So now I will request Sri Arun Kumar Jindalji, kindly start the session with their valuable words. Sir, please start the session. Arun sir,
Hello, Arun sir. We are unable to hear your voice. Arun sir? I would like to request all the our attendees for cooperation. As within 5 minutes, we are about to start the session. Due to some technical issues, we are unable to hear the voice of Arun sir. We are trying to fix the issues.
हेलो
या हेलो सर नाउ
मेरी आवाज आ गई
यस यस नाउ एबल टू हियर सर
यस 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 आई विल स्टार्ट गिव मी 5 मिनट
जी यस सर Sir, now voice is not coming. Not able to hear, sir.
Shall we start?
Yes, sir, please start the session.
Okay. Okay. Thank you very much. And sorry for delay start. Actually, there was some technical error, so I was not able to start. Now, without wasting the time, let me start with my presentation. I am Dr. Arun Kumar Jindal, President, Nursing Teacher Association of India, Haryana Branch. Thank you, President, Nursing Teacher Association of India. To give me this opportunity teach about some thing regarding the theories. So it was a great initiative taken by Nursing Teacher Association of India for arranging this type of webinar. In this webinar, I had been given the two theories. First, the Hilgard-Papluss interpersonal relationship theory. So without wasting the time, let me start with the theory, Hilgard-Papluss interpersonal relationship theory. So before talking about the interpersonal relationship theory, let us discuss something regarding the theorist Hilgard-Papluss biography. So Hilgard-Papluss, full name was the Hilgard Elizabeth Papluss. She was born in September 1, 1909. And been passed away in March 17, 1990. Around 90 years she was alive, and she was an American nurse who is the only one to serve the American Nurses Association as executive director, and later she has become the president. She became the first published nursing theorist since Florence Nightingale. Papluss was well known for her theory of interpersonal relationship theory, and definitely she has worked in the field of psychiatric nursing, and later on she was called as mother of psychiatric nursing for her extensive work for the interpersonal relationship theory. In early life, if you talk about the Hilgard-Papluss was born, as I told you, September 1, 1909. She was the second daughter, having two sisters and three brothers. With her younger age, Papluss' eagerness to grow beyond traditional Hilgard-Papluss was born on September 1, 1909. She was the second daughter, having two sisters and three brothers. With her younger age, Papluss' eagerness to grow beyond traditional woman's role was precise. She was one of the Am I audible to everybody?
Yes, sir, audible.
Okay, thank you. So now, in few career choice, she has chosen the nursing. And as you know, the 100 years ago, around 1980, there was a flu academic came as which we are seeing today as coronavirus. Okay, COVID-19 disease condition which we are seeing today. Before around 100 years ago in 1980, the flu was the epidemic all over the world. And during that time, when she was found her as very small and she was not able to do anything, so she has felt that she has to join for something where she can do something for the society or for dying person. In the when the Nightingale Airs was coming out and there was no many practical books was available for the nurses, and during that time it was seen that nurses was a nursing as a source of free or inexpensive labor. You are able to get it my point. Inexpensive labor. So that during that time, nurses' condition was very pathetic. During that time, she has choose to be as a nurse. In 1931, she graduated in a Pottstown, Pennsylvania School of Nursing. Peplus earned a bachelor degree in the interpersonal psychology in 1943, and so on. She has got many degrees. Career and appointment, if we see the Hilgard Peplus, after graduation in Pennsylvania, Hilgard Peplus then worked as a staff nurse in her place in New York. She was engaged in the summer camps in the New York, and slowly she has become the school nurse. And after this, she has gone for extensive work of interpersonal relationship theory. During that time, Sullivans has worked in the interpersonal relationship a lot of, and Hilgard Peplus interpersonal relationship theory for the nursing was somewhere motivated by solving interpersonal theories. She has served in the army where she has won the COP, and she has got the assignment to the 312 Field Station Hospital from 1943 to 45 in England. And so on, she was going doing the things for the mental health, and she has got the time to spare the time with a lot many British and American psychiatrists. Those were the known personally that time. Slowly, when she has been retired in 1974, she has become the professor and emeritus at the said university. She was going for the many universities for teaching the interpersonal relationship theory. During the 1950s and 60s, she supervised the summer workshop. She has nursed throughout the United States, mostly in the state of psychiatric hospital. In this seminar, she taught interpersonal concept and interviewing technique, as well as the individual, family, and group therapy. She is involved in her theory, the individual, the family, and the group. Peplus was an advisor to the World Health Organization and was a visiting professor at universities in Africa, Latin America, Belgium, and throughout the United States. She was the only nurse who served the ANA as executive director, and later she has become the president. Her 50 years career in nursing left an unforgettable mark on the field and on the life of mentally challenged in the United States during the peak of her career. She has done a lot of work in the psychiatric nursing. I'm not going to waste the much time regarding this. She has got lot many awards and honors. Numerous awards she has got and her contribution, and held the 11 honorary degrees. She was awarded honorary doctorate degree from university, including Alpha, Duke, Indiana, Ohio University, and many more. Hilgard Papillon's interpersonal relationship theory. Hilgard Papillon's interpersonal relationship theory emphasizes the nurse's client relationship at the foundation of nursing practices. It gives emphasis on give and take of nurse-client relationship that was seen by many as revolutionary. Papillon went on to form an interpersonal model emphasizing the need for a partnership between nurse and client, as it was opposed to the client passively receiving treatment and nurses passively acting on doctor's order. During her time, nurses was not much given the concentration. It was thought to be that she has to carry out the doctor's order. So it was something like the doctor has written the order, nurses are following that order and giving the medication to the patient, and patient is passively receiving this medications. So opposed to that, she has told that there must be a relationship between the patient, or called as client, and the nurse. Nurse and client has to make one relationship, and that relationship should be called as interpersonal relationship. The emphasis was on interpersonal relationship, was on relationship between the client and the nurse. The four component of the theory was person, which is a developing organism that tries to reduce anxiety. A person who, I'm telling here person or client, because this interpersonal relationship theory was not concise to only the hospital. It may extend to the community itself. Okay, so that's what I say. Here the person who is having the anxiety, for reducing the anxiety, the person is approaching to the nurse. That is called as a client or person. The environment, which consists of existing force outside of the person and put in the context of culture. This force which is creating the anxiety among to the person may be hidden or outer, which can be seen or which cannot be seen. Health, which is a word symbol that implies forward movement of personality, and the nursing, which is a significant therapeutic interpersonal process that function cooperatively with others, human process that make health possible for individual in community. The nursing model identifies four sequential phases in the interpersonal relationship. This is very much important, that when we talk about the interpersonal relationship theory, there are the four sequential phases. These are the orientation phase, identification phase, exploitation phase, and resolution phase. So for developing interpersonal relationship, you have to undergo for these all four phases, which is the orientation, identification, exploitation, and resolutions. It is also included seven nursing roles. That is, nurse may be the stranger for the client, may be the resource role, teaching role, counseling, counselor's role, surrogative role, active leadership, and technical expert's role. We'll discuss them one by one in later stages. What were the assumptions of this theory? When she has started thinking about this theory, she has thought that the nurse and the client can interact. Keep in mind, in later stage, I will make you understand what was the drawback of this theory, because Hilgard Papillon has thought that this can be between the client and the patient who can interact each other. So this is a point which we will discuss in later stage. Papillon emphasized that both the patient and the nurse mature as a result of therapeutic interactions. She has thought the communication and interviewing skill remain fundamental nursing tool. And lastly, the Papillon believe that nurses must clearly understand themselves to promote their client growth and to avoid limiting the client's choice to those that nurses value. The major concepts of interpersonal relationship theory are, as I discussed previously, the client. According to Papillon, client is an organism that strives in its own way to reduce tension generated by needs. Client is an individual with a felt need. Person who have the felt need and is not able to fulfill that or not able to get it, the solution for that, maybe the client or maybe the individual to you. Health is defined as a word symbolic that implies forward movement of the personality and other ongoing human process in the direction of creative, constructive, productive, personal and community living. Society or environment, although Pablo does not directly address the society or environment, she does encourage nurse to consider the patient's culture and more when the patient adheres to the hospital routine. According to the Papliu, the nursing was to be a significant therapeutic interpersonal process. She defined it as a human relationship between an individual who is sick or in need of health services and a nurse, especially educated to recognize and to respond to the need for the help. So making this interpersonal relationship between a client or a nurse, you have to go for the four therapeutic phases. What are these four phases? First, the orientation phase. In the orientation phase, nurse and client meet each other and they give the orientation to each other. In that, the problem defining phase start when the client meet nurse as a stranger. Here, nurse may be the stranger to the client and client may be the stranger to the nurse. So both will explain each other. Both will start giving the orientation about each other, defining the problem and deciding the type of services needed. Client seek assistance, convey need, ask questions, share, and with the past experience. Nurse respond, explain role to the clients, help to identify problem and to use available resources and services. In the orientation phase, nurse and client meet each other, explain about each other and discuss the problem and try to have the faith on each other. Second phase, when the orientation phase complete, then the second phase start with, this is called the identification phase. In the identification phase, begin when the client work interdependently with the nurse, express feeling and begin to feel stronger. Selection of appropriate professional assistance. Patient begin to have a feeling of belonging and capability of being with the problem. With decrease the feeling of helplessness and hopelessness. When the nurse and clients have the belief on each other, they started expressing or sharing their ideas with each other in the orientation phase. In the second phase, they will able to share the things and then now here the patient who was feeling the helplessness or hopelessness will start reducing. In the third phase, which is called as an exploitation phase, here the all the resources which is are available for the benefit of the client will be utilized maximum. In the exploitation phase, the client make full use of services offered, use of professional assistant for problem solving alternatives. Advantages of services are used based on the need and trust of the patient. The individual feel like an integral part of the helping environment. They may make minor requests or attention getting tactics. The principle of interview technique must be used in order to explore, understand and adequately deal with the underlying problem. It is or very, very much important here. Lastly, I'll tell you that this was the importance of this theory, that there is an interview technique or the communication was very much important for this theory. In that, when patient has got the orientation, after the orientation, client and nurse has got the identification phase, then they have gone to the exploitation phase. When the thing has become settled and the maximum participation of the client been seen, now the resolution phase comes. In the resolution phase, the client no longer need the professional services and give up dependent behavior, the relationship end. Here it is very much important, my dear participants, that you also will be seeing in the hospital that when you are working or you are working in the hospital, your many when the client come to you, you start developing the interpersonal relationship between the patient. You start calling them uncle, auntie, or with the name or whatever it is, and start giving them that you are there to help them. Slowly, the client also developed the faith on you, and they started following you. Many times I have seen that many clients express that I need the care from that particular nurse, or I need the care from this particular nursing officer. So this is the situation become. But you must understand that this is for the time being, for improving the patient or to giving the maximum care to the patient, but it is not for the life long. So you must keep that at the end, the resolution phase is going to come. And this resolution phase, sometimes it become very difficult that client and the nurse have this type of relationship that which is not able to get it to terminate. But as a professional, we must understand that this all relationship was for the professional profession purpose, and now this has to be resolved or it has to be terminated when the client is no longer required for professional services. I think I will be able to explain you in a proper way. Now let us discuss the sub concept of interpersonal relationship theory. So as I said that here the nurses' role, nurses in the therapeutic relationship identified by the PEPLUS are the role of nurses, which is identified the PEPLUS are first the stranger, offering the client the same acceptance and courtesy that the nurse would be put to any stranger. First time when the client is meeting the nurse, she will be the stranger. But this stranger has to be reduced, and the faith has to come between the client and nurse. Nurse can be a resource person who can specify answer to the question with a large context that the client to get the faith from the client, you must able to give the answer to the all the question which the client is asking, and which is the scientific answer which should not be the which should not be bushing running around the bush. Nurse can work as a teacher, helping the client to learn formally or informally. Nurse can be the leader for the client for giving the direction. She also can be as a surrogate, but doing a surrogate, serving as a substitute of another, such as the parents or a sibling. Sometimes the client who is admitted to your hospital may be maybe the alone, maybe feeling loneliness. Parents may not be the along with the patient, or siblings whom he or she is missing may not be. So nurse's role is to fulfill all that role which the patient missing. A nurse can be a counselor, promoting experience leading to the health for the client, such as the expression of feeling. Okay, the hidden thing has to come, or covered thing has to be come out, and that has to has this also has to be given the solution. She also has to work as a technical expert. This was some role which was been told by Ligard W. Other than that, also she was talking, but she has not given the much. She has not talked much about this. That was a technical expert, there was a consultant, health teacher, tutor, socializing agent, safety agent, manager of environment, mediator, administrator, record observer, and researcher. Now, for this interpersonal relationship, the important thing was which in beginning I talked about anxiety. And what is the anxiety? Anxiety was defined as the initial response to the psychic threat that have the four stages. So when the person feel lonely, person feel hopeless, person see helpless, that time the anxiety comes. This anxiety will have at different levels. First level is the mild level, that is the positive state of heightened awareness and sharpened sense, allowing the person to learn new baby and solve problem. The person can take in all available stimuli. As a client come to your ward, come to you and may ask many questions. So mild anxiety may not be taken much pressure, because it is in a positive state. Because if you are giving some medication or you are doing some procedure or you are asking, telling something to the patient may or client may ask you the question to you, and it is for clearing the whatever the questions patient is having. So there is nothing to worry. Second, the moderate anxiety involve a decreased perceptual field. The person can learn a new behavior or solve problem only with the assistant. Another person can redirect the person to the task. Neither severe anxiety, which must be taken as serious, because due to this anxiety, patient may develop some type of physiological symptoms like the tachycardia, diaphoresis, and the chest pain. And panic anxiety, which is very, very much serious, can involve loss of rational thought, delusion, hallucination, and complete physical immobility and muteness. The person may bolt and run aimlessly, often exposing himself or herself to the injury. Now, the interpersonal theory and nursing process. So, as we in assessment phase, we must continuously collect the data from the client, which may not be the felt need. In the orientation phase, non-continuous data collection, felt need also include, and definite need also can be included. Nursing diagnosis and planning. In this, the client and nurse both mutually will set the goal. And identification phase, interdependent goal setting. Implementations, where the plan initially toward the achievement of mutually set goals may be accomplished by the patient, nurse, or significant others. Exploitation phase, where the patient actively seeking and drawing help patient initial in a evaluation phase, in a nursing process I'm talking, based on mutually expected behavior may lead to termination and initial of new plans. If you have achieved your goal, well and good. If you are not achieved your goal or your objectives are not fulfilled, the whole plan has to be rotated again. In the resolution phase, in the interpersonal relationship theory of Hilgard Peplu, where occurs after other phases are completed successfully, lead to termination. Which in the beginning of which I was talking that this Peplu's theory was depend on the interaction between the patient and client and the nurse. The idea of the nurse-client interaction is limited with those individuals incapable of conversing specific those who are unconscious. So interpersonal relationship theory was not able to get it, the implementation in the patient, those are unconscious, those are not able to follow the nurse's instructions, or those are not able to give the interview, or those are not able to communicate in a proper way. So this was a drawback of this Peplu's theory, which was in a beginning, which I was trying to tell you. But it was having the strength that it was regarding the natural progress of nurse-patient relationship, which lead to adaptability in the any nurse-patient interaction, thus providing the generalization. But the weakness was, which I told you, that though Peplu stressed the nurse-client relationship as the foundation of nursing practice, health promotion and maintenance were less emphasized. Also, the theory cannot be used in a patient who does not have a felt need, such as withdrawn patient, a person in a psychiatric, which I told the panic stage where the patient has withdrawn himself or herself from the communication, or patient is not able to develop the much belief on the nurse, will not be able to communicate. And when the communication will not be there, then this interpersonal relationship theory cannot be applicable. So this was the weakness of this interpersonal relationship theory. So this is something about the Hilgard-Papillius interpersonal relationship theory. So next, let us move to another theory.
Dear participants, one Papillius theory has been completed by Dr. Arun Kumar sir. Any queries are there can drop in QA box, and after the session completion of the session, it will be asked.
So let us start with the second theory.
Yes, sir. Please proceed.
Okay. So let me start with another one theory. Faye Abdallah's 21 nursing problem theory. The theory name itself, the 21 nursing problem theory. So lastly, say how I was talking about the Hilgard-Papillius theory, where the interpersonal relationship theory was only able to implement in the person those are able to communicate. Here also, again, in the last, I'll tell you that how the Faye Abdallah only was discussing about the nurses, not her. She was talking about the client, but slowly her work has been shifted from client to nursing problems itself. So let us discuss the theory. Before starting this theory, let me make you aware about who was the Faye Abdallah, about some biography of Faye Abdallah. Faye Galen Abdallah, who was she was born in March 13, 1999, was a pioneer in nursing research that developed the 21 nursing problem. Her model of nursing was progressive for the time in that it refers to a nursing diagnosis. During a time in which nurses were taught that the diagnosis were not part of their role in the healthcare system. So during that time, she has given the 21 nursing diagnosis, and later this has become the base for nursing diagnosis, which we are following today. She was the first nurse officer to earn the ranking of a 2-star rear admiral, and the first nurse and the first woman to serve as a deputy surgeon general. In her early lifehood, what was the turning point for Faye Abdallah's life? As I told, she was born in March 13, 1919 in New York. Her father were Algerian heritage, and the mother was Scottish. Her family subsequently moved to New Jersey, where she attended high school. A year later, in the May 6, 1937, the German hydrogen-fueled airship Hindenburg exploded over Leuchart. Abdallah and her brother witnessed the explosion, destruction, and the fire subsequently to the ignited hydrogen that killed many people. That incident became the turning point in Abdallah's life. So during this time, when there were ignited hydrogen and many people were killed, that time she was small, and she was not able to do anything for the life of people. But she has decided that this will not repeat again, and she will become the something where she can serve for the human. And she has selected the nurse as a profession for the education, Fi Abdullah earned a nursing diploma from Franklin Memorial Hospital School of Nursing, now which is known as Anne May School of Nursing. It was sufficient for practicing as a nurse that time, but she has not stopped herself. And she believed that the nursing care should be based on the research, because that time when the nursing was not much having the emphasis of scientific knowledge, there was no evidence-based practices was not there. The research was not being done, carried out in the nursing. And the thing which is being available that was taught to the nursing students, and students used to follow that without taking the asking the scientific reason behind of that. And this was a journey of Fi Abdullah's career. And with her advanced education, Abdullah could have been chosen to become a doctor, which she has told in her interview somewhere. But she has told that I like to be a nurse. As an educator at her early 20s, Fi Abdullah worked as a health nurse at a private school, and her first administrative position was in the faculty of Yale University from 1945 to 49. At the time, she was required to teach a class called 120 Principles of Nursing Practices. When she has joined for her job in 1945 to 49, there was one class was given for her to teach 120 Principles of Nursing Practices. And using a standard nursing textbook published by the National League for Nurses, which was available that time. But that book include guidelines that had no significant basis, which challenged Abdullah to explain everything to what she called the brilliant student. The student those was whom she was teaching, they used to ask the question, or otherwise she was not able to explain to her students about this 120 principles. So after a year, Abdullah became so frustrated, and what she has done, she has called her friends in a university campus ground and brought all the books from the library and burned them, because she was telling that without scientific reason, if we are teaching this type of book to the student, it will be the harmful and it will give the wrong impact to the patient. And later it has become the difficulty for her, and making the people understand took a lot of time for her. But whatever she has destroyed, she was never felt that it was done wrong from her side. As a researcher in 1949, she met Lucille Petry Leon, who was the first nurse officer, and decided to join in the public health services. Her first assignment was with the Division of Nursing, with focus to research and studies. So you can see it, she was the Fi Abdullah, who was holding one white paste in her hand. Okay. As her career progressed, her research evolved, including philosophy, chemistry, behavioral science, etc. The home care, which is progressive patient care question, was not widely accepted in the mid-20th century. Abdullah explained that the people at the time kept saying that home care means having a maid or a nurse in everyone's home. You can understand the time where the Abdullah has spoken for the nursing was that people used to compare between the nurse and the maid. They used to say the maid and the nurse are equal, and they can be kept to each home for taking care of the household works. So very pathetic time was that. Slowly, Abdullah has got different positions and different administrative positions in the different departments, and she has earned a lot of awards in her records. slowly she has joined the military services. During her 40s year career, a commissioned officer in the US Public Health Services from 1949 to 89, Abdullah was assigned to work with the Korean people during the Korean War as a senior officer. She was alternatively assigned to the Japan, China, Russia, Australia to identify the role of the public health services in dealing with various health problems. She was able to assist and intimate in an advisory role numerous studies in the those countries. She served as a chief nursing officer from 1970 to 87 and was the first nurse to achieve the rank of two-star flag officer and the named by US Surgeon General. So this is something about the Abdullah's biography. Let us discuss the Abdullah's typology of 21 nursing problems. Faye Abdullah is well known for her development of the 21 nursing problem theory that was interrelated the concept of health, nursing problem, and problem solving. She viewed nursing as an art and science that molds the attitude, intellectual competencies, and technical skills of the individual nurse into the desire and ability to help individual cope with their health needs, whether they are ill or well. She used Henderson's 14 basic human needs and nursing research to establish the classification of nursing problems. As previously I said, there are a lot of awards was in her has given to her. Her publication include Better Nursing Care Through Nursing Research and Patient Central Approach to Nursing. She also developed education material in many areas for public health nursing, including the AIDS and hospice care and drug addiction. She has got the Pioneer Research in Aging and Sigma Theta Tau Lifetime Achievement Award. Aside from being the first nurse and the first woman to serve as a Deputy Surgeon General, Faye Galen Abdullah also made a name in the nursing profession with the formulation of 21 Nursing Problem Theory. According to the Faye Galen Abdullah theory, nursing is based on the art and science that mold the attitude, intellectual competencies, and the technical skills of the individual nurse into the desire and ability to help people sick or well cope with their health and needs. So here she was talking about the nurses and nurses' role and what are the nursing problems. Her work has been shifted from patient-centered to the nurse-centered. The patient-centered approach to the nursing was developed from Abdullah's practice, and the theory is considered a human need theory. It was formulated to be instrumental for nursing education. So it is most suitable and useful in the field. The nursing model is intended to guide care in the hospital institution, but can also be applied to community health nursing as well. What was her assumption? She has thought that 21 nursing problem theory related to change and anticipated change that affect nursing, the need to appreciate the of social enterprises, of social problems, of the impact of the problems such as poverty, racism, pollution, education, and so forth on health and healthcare delivery, changing nursing education. Continuing education for professional nurses and development of nursing leader from under subgroup. She said that as a nurse, you must learn to know the patient, sort out relevant and significant data, make generalization about the available data in relation to similar nursing problem presented by other patient, identify the therapeutic plan, test generalization with the patient and make additional generalization, validate the patient conclusion and about its general nursing problems, continue to observe, evaluate the patients over a period of time to identify any attitude and clues affecting this behavior, explore the patient and family reaction to the therapeutic plan and involve them in the plan, identify how the nurse feel about the patient nursing problem, discuss and develop a comprehensive nursing care plan. So according to the Fay Abdillah's nursing theory, the meta paradigm was first the individual. According to her, she described the recipient of nursing as individual. Here, maybe the client or maybe the family also. Although she does not determine her belief or assumption about the nature of human beings. In her meta paradigm, she has told the health or the achieving of its is the purpose of nursing services. Although Abdillah does not give a definition of health, she speaks to total health need and a healthy state of mind and body. Health may be defined as a dynamic pattern of functioning whereby there is a continuous interaction with internal and external force that result in the optimal use of necessary resources to minimize the vulnerability. According to her, the society is included a planning for optimal health on local state and the interactional level. However, as Abdillah further delimits her ideas to focus on nursing services is clearly by the individual. Nursing problem, according to her, the client is health need can be viewed problem which may be overt as an apparent condition or covered as a hidden or concealed one. Because covered problem can be emotional, sociological or social and interpersonal in nature, they are often missed or perceived. Yet in many instances may solve in the overt problem as well. So if according to her, she said the problem within the person or outside the person, both has to be given the chance and both has to be getting the solution. If you are correcting the problem which is within the person or covered problems or concealed problem may give the solution to the problem which is outside the person. Problem solving, quality professional nursing care require the nurse to be able to identify and solve overt and covered nursing problem. This requirement can be met by the problem solving process involve identifying the patient's problem, selecting patient's data, formulating the hypothesis, testing hypothesis through collection of data and revising hypothesis when necessary on the basis of conclusion obtaining from the data. So what are the sub concept of Abdillah's nursing 21 nursing problems? These are some of the typology of 21 nursing problems by the Fay Abdillah. She said that to maintain a good hygiene and physical comfort, she said to prompt optimal activity, exercise and rest and sleep. She said to promote the safely through prevention and accident. She's talk about the elimination need. She talk about the good body mechanism. Let us talk this all one by one. So what was the her Abdillah's 21 nursing problems which she talked? She talked to maintain the good hygiene and physical comfort. She said to promote optimal activities, that means exercise, rest and sleep, to promote safety through prevention of accident, injuries or other trauma through prevention of spread of infection, to maintain a good body mechanism and prevent and correct deformities, to facilitate the maintenance of support of oxygen to all body cells, to facilitate the maintenance of nutrition for all body cells, to facilitate the maintenance of elimination, to facilitate the maintenance of fluid and electrolyte balance, to recognize the physiological responses of the bodies to disease, condition, pathological, physiological and compensatory, to facilitate the maintenance of regulatory mechanism and functions, to facilitate the maintenance of sensory functions, to identify and accept positive and negative expressions, feeling and reactions, to identify to identify and accept interrelatedness of emotion, organic illness, to facilitate the maintenance of effective verbal and normal communication, to promote the development of productive interpersonal relationship, to facilitate progressive towards achievement and professional spiritual goals, to create a maintenance and therapeutic environment, to facilitate awareness of set as an individual with verifying physical, emotional, and developmental needs, to accept the optimal possible goal in the lights for limitations, physical and emotional, to use community resources as an aid in resolving problems that arise from the illness, to understand the role of social problem as an influence factor in the cause of illness. So these were the 21 nursing problems which was told by the Faye Abdella. The basic needs, she talked about the basic need of an individual patients are to be maintained. Which are the basic needs? Are the basic needs are the good hygiene. So these all 21 nursing problem which Abdella's talk, she has given them in a sub topics like the basic need, the substantial care need, the remedial care need, and the restorative care need. In the basic need, she has told that the good hygiene, the physical comfort, the promotion, optimal health through healthy activities such as exercise, rest, and sleep can promote safety through the prevention of health hazards like accident, injury, or health trauma, and through the prevention of spread of infection and maintenance good body mechanism and prevention of correct deformities. Second subtopic was sustainable care need. Sustainable care need facilitate the maintenance of supply of oxygen to all body cells, facilitating the maintenance of nutrition of all body cells, facilitating the maintenance of elimination facility, facilitate the maintenance of fluid and electrolyte balance, recognize the physiological response of the body to disease condition, facilitate the maintenance regulatory mechanism and function, and facilitate the maintenance of sensory functions. In remedial care need, where she has talked the positive and negative expressions, feeling and reactions, identify and accept the interrelatedness of the emotional and organic illness, facilitate the maintenance of effective and verbal and non-verbal communications, promote the development of productive interpersonal relationship, facilitate progress towards the achievement of personal spiritual goal. In the restorative care need, she has talked about the in the light of limitations, she has talked about both physical and emotional, the use of community resources as an aid to resolve problem that arise from the illness, and as understanding the role of social problems as influential factor in the case of illness. Abdella has find out the 10 steps to do this, as person must be or nurse should have must know the patient. She has to sort out the relevant and significant data. She has to make generalization about available data in relation to similar nursing problem presented by the patient, identify the therapeutic plan, test generalization with patient and make additional generalization, validate the patient's conclusion about his nursing problem, continue to observe and evaluate the patients over a period of time to identify any attitude and clues affecting his or her behavior, explore the patient and his or her family reaction to the therapeutic plan and involve them in the plan, identify how the nurse feel about the patient's nursing problem, discuss and develop a comprehensive nursing care plan. She has given the 11 nursing skills what the nurse must have to do this. She should be a good observer, she should have the good skill for communication, she should have the application of knowledge which she has, she should be a good teacher for the patient and his family, she should be a good planner and should have be able to organize the work, use of resource material in a maximum level, use of personal resources, problem solving, direction of work of other, therapeutic use of self-care, that means you must involve yourself also as a nurse to give the therapeutic care to the patient and nursing procedures. Abdullah also explained nursing as comprehensive service. This include recognize the nursing problem of the patient, deciding the appropriate course of action to take in terms of relevant nursing principles, provide continuous care of the individual total need, provide continuous care to the to relieve pain and discomfort, and provide immediate security for the individual, adjusting the total nursing care plan to meet the patient's individual needs, helping the individual to become more self-directing in attaining or maintaining a healthy state of body and mind, instructing nursing personnel and family to help the individual do for himself the which he can within the his limitations, helping the individual to adjust to his limitation emotional problems, work with allied health profession in the planning for optimum health on local, state, national, and international level, carrying out continuous evaluation and research to improve nursing techniques and to develop new technique to meet people's health need. Patient-centered approach to the nursing. In that, Faye Abdullah work is a set of problems formulated in terms of nursing-centered services, which are used to determine the patient's need. The nursing-centered orientation to the client care appears to be contraindicating to the client-centered approach, which in beginning I told you that the care, the main motto to improve the patient's client's condition. But in working of improving the client's condition, Abdullah has shifted herself from this to the improving to finding out the problems of nursing. So this was she has become the pendulum where somewhere she has kept client's need in between, and she was moving toward the nursing problem. 21 nursing problem with the nursing process in the so how you can implement this in a nursing process. First, in the assessment phase, the nursing problems identify standard procedure for data collection. A principle underlying the problem solving approach is far as each individual identification problem pertaining to data is collected, the overt or covert nature of problem necessitate a direct or indirect approach respectively. So the data may be collected from the patients, which may be the directive or indirective, or maybe the covert or overt problem may be assessed over here. The outcome of the collection of data in the first phase concludes the possible problem of the patient, which can be grouped under one or more of the broader nursing problems. This will further lead to the nursing diagnosis. Okay, so when you have decided, you have find out the data, you have done the assessment and plotted the data. According to that, you may find out the possible problems, and these possible problems of the patient may be kept in subgroup of the 21 nursing problem which we discussed earlier. After formulating the diagnosis, nursing care plan is developed and appropriate nursing interventions are determined. The nurses now set those interventions in action which complete the implementation phase of the nursing process. The evaluation takes place after intervention have been carried out. The most convenient evaluation would be the nurse's progress or lack of progress toward the achievement of goal established in planning the phase. So let us analyze how the Abdullah's 21 nursing problem approach was. With the aim of Abdullah's in formulating the clear categorization of patient's problem as health need, she rather conceptualized nurse's action in nursing care, which is contrary to her aim. Nurse's role were defined to eliminate the problem assessed through the proposed problem solving approach. The problem solving approach introduced by Abdullah was the advantage of increasing the nurses' critical analytic thinking skills, since the care to be provided would be based on the sound assessment and validation of findings. Definitely, this nurse, what she has planned was good because it was on the base of scientific research. On the base of scientific research, only this 21 nursing problem was found out. But she supposed to do something for the patient, but it has moved from the patient to the nurses center care. One can identify that the framework is strongly applied to the individual as the focus of nursing care. The inclusion of an aggregate of the people such as the community or society would make the theory of Abdullah more generalized, since nurses do not only provide one person service, especially now that the community healthcare level is shown to have the higher importance than curative effect in the hospital. What was the strength of this theory? The problem-solving approach is readily generalizable to the clients with specific health need and specific nursing problem. With the modern nature, healthcare provider and the practitioners can use Abdullah's problem-solving approach to guide various activities within the client setting. This is true when considering nursing practices that deal with the clients who have specific need and specific nursing problem. So either you are giving the care in the client hospital side or you are giving the service in the community. According to the 21 nursing problem approach, you may select what are the problems your client is having, and according to that, you may go for planning. But what are the weakness? Weakness was that the major limitation to the Abdullah's series and the 21 nursing problem is that they are very strong nurse center orientation. She rather conceptualized nurses action in nursing care, which is contrary to her aim. Another point is the lack of emphasis on what the client is to achieve was given in terms of the client's care. Framework seems to focus quite heavily on nursing practices and individuals. So somewhere doing the work for the patient, she has moved herself for the nurse centered. So this was the some weakness which is being felt in the Abdullah's theory. So here I complete my both theories. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Arun sir. It was very excellent presentation. And now this time is a question and answer session. So I have collected some questions which has been asked by the participants. Ms. Sonam Dhiman, she has asked, sir, can you please repeat the strength and weakness of Papilio theory?
Hilgard Papilius?
Yes.
Okay, I'll share.
She want strength and weakness. What are the strength and what are the weakness of Papilio theory?
Okay, see, strength was Papilio's theory helped later nursing therapists and clinicians develop more therapeutic intervention regarding the role that shows the dynamic character typical in clinical nursing. Its phase provides simplicity regarding the natural progression of nurse-patient relationship, which lead to adaptability in any nurse-patient interaction, thus providing the generalizability. But the weakness was that nurse-client relationship as the foundation of nurse practice, health promotion and maintenance were less emphasis. I make you understand that it was good where the nurse and client can interact each other, but where the nurse and client is not able to interact each other, like the patient is admitted to the ward with unconscious, or the patient who is not able to communicate with you, or a withdrawn patient where your nurse is not able to interact with the patient. When the nurse or client is not having the interaction, the interpersonal relationship cannot be maintained. When this cannot be maintained, this will be very difficult for the developing interpersonal relationship, and this theory cannot be implemented in that situation. So this was the weakness of this theory.
Thank you, sir. The next question is Tisha Thomas has asked, how the Papilio's theory can be used for a follow-up patient or a patient with chronic illness?
Yes, definitely this theory can be followed. No theorist has said that this is any theory which is concise to only the hospital base. All theories are can be implemented in a community as well as in the hospital. So here the Papilio said that when the patient is having the chronic illness but is not but able to interact with you, you may give the you may develop the interpersonal relationship. And when the interpersonal relationship develop, that means the nurse and the client is having the belief at each other. When both are having belief at each other, they will share their ideas. The client who is having the questionnaires and the nurse who is having the answer for that. Nurse will give the answer, and the problem which the question which the client is having will be get solution. By this, the nurse and client's relationship will develop. And it may be useful in the chronic patient. Those are in a say, I'll give you the example of patient who is having the oncology problem or having the cancer. Definitely the person is going to die, but peaceful death in health definition also it has been told that peaceful death is very much important. So here the nurse may give solution for the patient, or will find out the resources how the patient will have the peaceful death, or how the patient will have the painless movements for there. So this theory can be implemented for the chronic patients or in a community based also.
Thank you, sir. And one of the questions, and I request to all the participants that please ask the question in QA box only, not in the chat box. And next question is, can we use different theory for different Nanda nursing diagnosis? If yes, then in nursing columns, only name of the theory should included, or any other explanation?
I need to please repeat the question to me.
Yes. Question is, can we use different theory for different Nanda nursing diagnosis? If yes, then in nursing column, only name of the theory should be included, or any other explanation is there?
It is just a suggestion from that side. Okay. This is the work of research and the leaders of nursing must think about that we should write the name of the person whose theory we are using for the assessment phase. It's a good idea from your side.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Next question, Dr. B. L. Sharma has asked, sir, how can applied the theory in the practice?
Applied theory?
Yes.
Can you repeat me question?
How can applied the theory in the practice?
Yes, both in both the theories I told, being a nurse, we used to plan the nursing care plan. And in both theories, when I was discussing, I have told you that in a nursing care plan, how you can use this theory for the assessment phase or for the planning phase or the diagnosis phase or evaluation phase in a Pablo's theory, also in a nursing Faye Abdallah's also. And Faye Abdallah's has given the 21 nursing diagnoses. According to that, only the later we have developed our nursing diagnosis. So these are the base of this. And in both the theories, when I was discussing, I told you that how the assessment has to be done, how the planning has to be done, how the goal has to be achieved, and how we can do the evaluation. Definitely, this has to be implemented in the nursing process.
Yes, thank you, sir. Because sir has already told that the theories can be applied in the practice also, because for practice only this theory has been developed. And the next question is Mr. Vikas Vishwakarma has asked, sir, can we apply Papilio theory in psychiatry patient? And how to establish IPR with bipolar patient?
Okay, I'll not talk about the bipolar patient because I'm not a psychiatric nurse, so will not be able to talk much about this. But definitely, the Papilio's theory has to be applied in the psychiatric patient or any other patient also, because if the person is able to communicate with you, the importance of this theory, again and again, I am telling, the weakness and the strength of this theory was the interaction between the patient. If the patient is able to interact with you, then only the relationship can be developed and then only the things can go ahead. If the interaction is not there, that means I told the patient who is having the withdrawn condition or the patient who is having the depressive patient or the patient who is not able to, who do not want to interact with you, then this theory cannot be implemented in this condition.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. Today's session has been completed. Sir has taken the Papilio theory related to the how to develop a IPR, interpersonal relationship. And the second one theory, Abdallah theory, and sir has told very nicely how, what are the needs and what are the emphasis of the theory, 21 needs or Abdallah theory, and why the Abdallah theory has been developed. He has explained very nicely and how can we apply this theory in the clinical practice or any which when in which condition we can apply it, sir has explained. So thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for the nice explanation and the nice session. Hope for the best. And tomorrow the session is not there because tomorrow is a Raksha Bandhan. And day after tomorrow, the session will be there. So thank you so much, sir. And thank you so much to all the participants who has taken part in this theory session. So thank you to all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Farooq ji. And it was great for me to interact with the nursing personnel of all over the country. And it was a great initiative taken from Nursing Teacher Association of India. And I hope in future you will be arranging this type of webinar and will be fruitful for our nursing profession, and our profession will get the heights in future. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.